Hello everybody, this is Punk, Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Sonic Adventure DX playthrough. Last time, we continued the story of Knuckles in Adventure Mode, going through Red Mountain and Lost World, as well as having an encounter with Chaos 4. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're actually approaching the end of the story for Knuckles, and in this episode, hopefully, Knuckles' story will be done and we'll be able to move on to the next character in adventure. At the end of the last episode, we found ourselves back here at the Master Emerald Altar after another vision of the past, and we've been able to mostly restore the Master Emerald. There is still a pretty good sized chunk of it missing, and it turns out that apparently the last pieces of the Master Emerald can be found on Dr. Eggman's egg carrier. Now you may be wondering, just how on earth are we going to get to the egg carrier? Knuckles may be able to glide, but obviously he cannot fly, and he doesn't have his own plane like Sonic and Tails do. So how is Knuckles going to get to the egg carrier, you may be wondering? Well,
no trains are currently in service.
At the end of the last episode, we managed to catch a glimpse of E-102 Gamma, one of Dr. Eggman's robots. And I think we're going to need to follow him if we want to find Eggman's fortress. And wouldn't you know it, out here, there is Dr. Eggman's base. Yes, Final Egg. Although we're not going to go through the level Final Egg with Knuckles. We do need to visit this area in order to get to the egg carrier with Knuckles, which we are about to do right now.
Just what I thought. Time to make a house call. We'll see who's so easily tricked. I can sense that the emeralds are here somewhere. What's going on? Ah, this thing's always changing.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we are back on the egg carrier, this time with Knuckles, and just like with Sonic and Tails, the egg carrier has changed configuration, which is going to complicate matters a little bit, but there is a way for Knuckles to access his next level by going into here. We go into this area here, we can go into what looks like a little pool area. I guess this is like a little rec room of sorts for Eggman. And if you climb this wall here and go up onto this platform, you can actually find an emblem. And although I'm not going for full completion for the emblems, I thought it would be a good idea to at least show off this location because yes, you can get another Adventure Field emblem here, which I already collected on a previous recording attempt. Had to do a little bit of a reset a moment ago. But nonetheless, it is in this area where we can find the entrance to the next and final level for Knuckles. That's right, Knuckles has only one level left.
I sense the Master Emerald. It can't be far from here.
Indeed, you are correct, Knuckles. In fact, if we want to find the last few pieces of the Master Emerald, we just need to walk in through this entryway to the Sky Deck, Stage 5. This is the fifth and final level for Knuckles, and we're going through what was the second, rather third area of Sky Deck for Sonic, and you may remember that level was constantly pitching and turning as we went through different segments of this area. There was a very good reason for that, and it's actually established for Knuckles' version that if we go back to the starting area, There's this lever up here.
The lever to control the ship's tilt.
As the little hint ball tells us, if we can push and pull the lever in different directions, that will cause the ship to tilt. So if you were wondering why the ship was going into crazy orientations when we were playing with Sonic, well, this is why. Someone was crazy enough to let Knuckles control the tilt of the ship. Whose idea was that, to let this crazy red echidna commandeer the ship? Fun fact about Knuckles as an echidna, for those who are not aware, is a real animal, although Knuckles actually doesn't look anything like a real echidna at all. I actually did some research on echidnas a couple days prior to this recording attempt, and basically, the thing about echidnas is that they look kind of like anteaters, but they're not truly related to anteaters. They're basically, they look like anteaters with spikes. Like, they kind of have spines, much like a hedgehog does. So I guess they're, in a way, they're kind of related to a hedgehog. So I guess Sonic and Knuckles share a relationship as far as their species is concerned. Anyway, if we go... Oops, sorry about that. Anyway, if we go into this area, there are diggable areas on the egg carrier in this level for Knuckles, and sure enough, we managed to find at least one emerald shard. Let's see if we can find the remaining ones. Ouch! Take that, enemy. Okay, let's see. Sometimes if you grab onto this hook and you go for a ride, there is actually sometimes an emerald piece floating in midair that you can grab by riding the hook. Obviously not this time. But the thing about the tilting mechanic that I brought up a moment ago, the thing about the tilting mechanic is that that is key depending on what mood the game is in. And depending on how the emerald pieces are positioned, you will have to tilt the ship in order to find them. Case in point, basically, all these doors you see that are opening and causing debris to fall out, basically we're going to have to get the ship to tilt in a way so that certain doors will open, allowing us to walk inside and actually collect the emerald piece, while dodging all the falling debris, of course. We might actually be coming close to an emerald piece. Yes! Somehow I managed to grab it. Now let's see. One emerald shard left. Anyway, back to the point about echidnas. Another thing about echidnas is that I personally have never seen an echidna. And that's because, based on my research, they're basically native to places like Australia and New Guinea. So yeah, probably not gonna see too many echidnas in the mid-Atlantic region of the United States. Virginia's not exactly an echidna hotspot, you know what I mean? Anyway, I think we're getting close to finding the last emerald shard. Need to be careful. Oh yeah, need to be careful with these blade enemies, because there are two versions of those blade enemies. There are the regular blade enemies, and then there are enemies that can electrify themselves so that if you try to attack them at the wrong moment, you're getting hurt. And just where on earth could this last emerald shard be? I may have to reorient the ship. It would also be a good idea to be aware of my surroundings so I don't get blindsided by a hazard. I wonder if it would be a good idea to go into first person. Let's see. Something tells me it may be... It's gotta be somewhere up in the in an upper region of the level. Because down here, it's not... The Emerald Radar is barely going off at all. I need to see if I can reset. That's one annoying thing about going through this level with Knuckles, is that if you want to reset the ship's tilt, you have to actually go all the way back to the starting position, because that's the only lever in the actual level. So yeah, that's how this level can take a while. Okay, let's go ahead and reset. Let's go ahead and bring everything back to square one, and we'll see if that helps in any capacity. Oh, I see it! I just saw a glimpse of it. It's at the very top of the level. Alright, let's go, Knuckles. Onwards and upwards for the final Emerald Shard that we're gonna have to collect. We're on top of the world! Literally, in this case. Also, one more note I want to make. The cutscene that played when we managed to infiltrate the egg carrier, where it's rising out of the Mystic Ruins, rising out of the jungle. I'll admit, when I was a kid, I actually found that cutscene very impressive. Just this massive machine rising from the ground like that. But enough about that. We got it. Done and dusted. Ha ha.
Good enough. The last missing piece. All right. Now, to restore the Master Emerald. Huh? Oh no, not again. What is the meaning of this?
Well, we have ourselves another vision of the past, ladies and gentlemen, and, things are about to get very dark. This is not much different from Sonic's vision that we had in his story. Something very bad has just happened.
Hey, what happened here?
I couldn't stop them. They came, and my father. I had no idea how bad this would turn out. I'm shocked.
Look, it's the Emerald. Wait. Is this a dream? It's more like a nightmare.
Your friends are in front of the ship fighting. Help them.
About to say, game, you gonna let me break open that capsule? Alright, folks, we've made it through Knuckles' final level, but the plot thickens. Funny I would say that this late in the game. The plot thickens a little bit, more visions of the past, and disaster has befallen the ancient Echidna civilization.
I finally found all of the missing emerald pieces, but I still can't figure out that creepy monster. Huh? What's that?
I think you know where this is all gonna end up, ladies and gentlemen. I think it's time we get to the front of the ship and discover the source of that light. I think it's gonna be something very familiar.
Not again! I hate you!
Hey, Sonic!
There you are, Knuckles. About time.
I will return.
Eggman, come back.
I'd better let Sonic handle it from here. He'll do okay. Now, I must return to Angel Island and the Master Emerald. No, it can't be. I guess he didn't get enough the first time. You can't stop me from restoring the Master Emerald.
Alright, let's get ready to throw down, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for the final boss of Knuckles' story. It's a rematch against Chaos 6. And this one isn't going to be quite as straightforward as our encounter with this creature as Sonic. The arena is going to be a little more compromised this time around. We're not going to be able to move quite so easily, and like there are two panels here, and if you touch the smoldering section of the ship, you will take damage. He still has this attack though, and he still has the attack where he'll try to suck you in. So attack wise, he's not that much more difficult according to my memory, but it is going to be a little harder to make him vulnerable because of the way the machines spawn. The little freezing machines, they'll go away after each cycle. They didn't really do that with Sonic. They would stay around, and it was easier to combo this thing with Sonic. Here, not so much. That time, I think he actually swallowed the freezing machine, so two hits down, looks like two hits left. Yeah, you do want to watch yourself. You're gonna have to be more careful, obviously, moving around the arena. But at its most basic level, this fight isn't really that much more difficult than it was with Sonic. Oh, there's a new attack. We did not see that attack with Sonic. He will do a ground stomp that will cause a shockwave. I'll admit, it caught me a little off guard. I thought he was just going to land like normal, but then that shockwave came and I didn't react quickly enough. He also has a different tail swipe attack. But this should do it.
Is that all you've got?
That's it, ladies and gentlemen. The story for Knuckles the Echidna is finished.
Return the Master Emerald safely to my island. This should do it. Perfect. All is well now. The Master Emerald and the island have been restored. I'll probably be on this floating island forever. Guarding the Master Emerald again. I may not know the whole story behind this, but perhaps it's better that way. I'm at peace once more.
Oh! All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to do it for Knuckles the Echidna in Sonic Adventure. So that is now Sonic, Tails, and now Knuckles. Their stories are fully complete, but we're only halfway through the story, ladies and gentlemen. There are still another three characters left to go: Amy, Big, and E-102 Gamma. So, with Knuckles out of the way, some quick thoughts. One thing I forgot to mention is that with the completion of Knuckles' story, a lot of levels we've been going through so far in this playthrough are basically going to be retired. Let me see here. Casinopolis, Lost World, Casinopolis, Speed Highway, Lost World, and Sky Deck. Those four levels, and I might have a couple wrong there, but I think at least those four levels are done for the entire playthrough. We will not be seeing those levels again as Amy, Big, or E-102. So yeah, definitely some levels are going to be retired now that we're done with Knuckles. But nonetheless, Knuckles, again, I'm not the biggest fan of his gameplay. The emerald hunting thing never really jived well with me. So of course they brought it back in Sonic Adventure 2, but that's a tangent that I'm not going to go on. So Knuckles' gameplay, not one of my favorites, although, like, I have no problem with Knuckles as a character, and as a character in the overall narrative of the story, he's arguably one of the most important, probably even the most important, with his connection to the Master Emerald. Because the Master Emerald is actually very important in the plot of the game. Excuse me there. But nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, our next character in line is going to be Amy Rose. But if you want to see her adventure, you're going to have to wait until the next episode because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Sonic Adventure DX playthrough. If you folks enjoyed this episode, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. And I hope to see all of you in the next episode! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, at this point in the playthrough, now that we are done with Sonic, Tails, and Knuckles, we are essentially halfway through the adventure mode, the story mode of Sonic Adventure DX. And with that in mind, I have decided to take a moment with this episode. I've decided to take a moment to sort of, I guess you could say, poll people a little bit. So if you've been following this playthrough, please let me know if you've been enjoying it so far, and if you are looking forward to the rest of the playthrough as I prepare to begin Amy's story in Adventure, and then move on to Big and E-102. So if you please, I would appreciate if you would give me your thoughts and feedback on the playthrough thus far, and if you're looking forward to what we have left. And with that out of the way, this is Punk Demon Neo signing out, and I hope to see all of you in the next video.